This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Cecil Blount DeMille, DML, August 12, 1881 to January 21, 1959 was an American filmmaker between 1913 and 1956. He made 70 features, both silent and sound films. He is acknowledged as a founding father of the Hollywood film industry, and the most commercially successful producer-director in cinema history. His films were distinguished by their epic scale and by his cinematic showmanship. He made silent films of every genre, social dramas, comedies, westerns, farces, morality plays, and historical pageants. DeMille began his career as a stage actor in 1900. He later moved to writing and directing stage productions, some with Jesse Lasky, who was then a vaudeville producer. DeMille's first film, The Squaw Man 1914, was also the first feature film shot in Hollywood. Its interracial love story made it a phenomenal hit and it put Hollywood on the map. The continued success of his productions led to the founding of Paramount Pictures with Lasky and Adolph Zukor. His first biblical epic, The Ten Commandments 1923, was both a critical and financial success. It held the Paramount revenue record for 25 years. In 1927 he directed The King of Kings, a biography of Jesus Christ, which was acclaimed for its sensitivity and reached more than 800 million viewers. The Sign of the Cross 1932 was the first sound film to integrate all aspects of cinematic technique. Cleopatra 1934 was his first film to be nominated for the Academy Award for Best Picture after more than 30 years in Hollywood. DeMille reached the pinnacle of his career with Samson and Delilah 1949, a biblical epic which did an all-time record business along with biblical and historical narratives. He also directed films oriented toward neo-naturalism, which tried to portray the laws of man fighting the forces of nature. He went on to receive his first nomination for the Academy Award for Best Director for his circus drama The Greatest Show on Earth 1952, which won the Academy Award for Best Picture. His last and most famous film, The Ten Commandments 1956, is currently the seventh highest grossing film of all time. Adjusted for inflation. In addition to his Best Picture Award, he received an Academy Honorary Award for his film contributions, the Palme d'Or posthumously for Union Pacific, a DGA Award for Lifetime Achievement, and the Irving G. Thalberg Memorial Award. He was also the first recipient of the Golden Globe Cecil B. DeMille Award, which was later named in his honor. Contents 1. DeMille Name 2. Family, Childhood, Youth 3. Career 31. Broadway 32. Moving Pictures 33. Silent Era 34. Sound Era 35. Showmanship as Director 36. The Ten Commandments 37. Unfulfilled Projects 4. Personal Life 5. Politics 6. Race and Religion 7. Death 8. Legacy 81. Posthumous Honors 9. Filmography 91. Director 92. Actor 10. Awards 11. See also 12. References 121. Notes 122. Sources 13. External links. DeMille name. There are several variants of DeMille's surname. His family's Dutch surname was originally spelled DeMille and then became DeMille as an adult. He adopted the spelling DeMille for professional purposes but continued to use DeMille in private life. The family name DeMille was used by his children Cecilia, John, Richard, and Catherine. DeMille's brother William and his daughters, Margaret and Agnes, as well as DeMille's granddaughter, Cecilia DeMille Presley, also used the DeMille spelling. Family, Childhood, Youth. Cecil Blount DeMille was born in Ashfield, Massachusetts, while his parents were vacationing there, and grew up in Washington, North Carolina. His father, Henry Churchill DeMille 1853-1893, was a North Carolina-born dramatist and lay reader in the Episcopal Church, who had earlier begun a career as a playwright, writing his first play at age 15. His mother was Matilda Beatrice DeMille née Samuel, whose parents were both of German-Jewish heritage. She emigrated from England with her parents in 1871 when she was 18, and they settled in Brooklyn. Beatrice grew up in a middle-class English household. DeMille's mother was related to British politician Herbert Louis Samuel. DeMille's parents met as members of a music and literary society in New York. Henry was a tall, red-headed student. Beatrice was intelligent, educated, forthright, and strong-willed. They were both born in 1853 and both loved the theater. When they married, Beatrice converted to Henry's faith. Henry worked as a playwright, administrator, and faculty member during the early years of the American Academy of Dramatic Arts, established in New York City in 1884. He built a house for his family in Wayne, New Jersey. The family spent time in Pompton Lakes, New Jersey, operating a private school in that town and attending Christ Christ Episcopal Church DeMille recalled that this church was the place where he visualized the story of his 1923 version of the Ten Commandments Henry read to his children nightly, both from the classics and from the Bible. DeMille studied scripture his entire life and read the Bible during lunch in the studio commissary. He was the first to admit that he did not attend church services, but he did profess an unshakable belief in prayer. He stated that his films were a continuation of his father's work. "My ministry," said DeMille, "has been to make religious movies and to get more people to read the Bible than anyone else ever has." In 1893, at the age of 40, Henry DeMille contracted typhoid fever and died suddenly, leaving Beatrice with three children, a house, and no savings. Beatrice had enthusiastically supported her husband's theatrical aspirations in his eulogy. She wrote, "May your sons be as fine and as noble and good and honest as you were. May they follow in your steps." Within 8 weeks of Henry's death, Beatrice opened an acting workshop in her home, the Henry C. DeMille School for Girls. She later became the second female play broker on Broadway. DeMille attended Pennsylvania Military College in Chester, Pennsylvania from the age of 15. Both DeMille class of 1900 and his brother William class of 1901 also attended and graduated from the American Academy of Dramatic Arts, which they attended on scholarship. The Academy later honored DeMille with an Alumni Achievement Award. Career C. 1904 Broadway. DeMille began his career as an actor on the Broadway stage in the theatrical company of Charles Frohman in 1900. His brother William was establishing himself as a playwright and sometimes invited him to collaborate. DeMille performed on stage with actors whom he would later direct in films: Charlotte Walker, Mary Pickford, and Pedro de Cordoba. DeMille also produced and directed plays. DeMille found success in the spring of 1913 producing Reckless Age by Lee Wilson, a play about a high society girl wrongly accused of manslaughter, starring Frederick Burton and Sidney Shields. DeMille and his brother at times worked with the legendary impresario David Belasco, who had been a friend and collaborator of their father. Changes in the theater rendered DeMille's melodramas obsolete before they were produced, and true theatrical success eluded him. By 1913, he was having difficulty supporting his wife and baby daughter moving pictures. In July 1913, DeMille, Jesse Lasky, Sam Goldfish, later Samuel Goldwyn, and a group of East Coast businessmen created the Jesse L. Lasky Feature Play Company. On December 12, 1913, DeMille, his cast, and crew boarded a Southern Pacific train bound for Flagstaff via New Orleans. His tentative plan was to shoot a film in Arizona, but he disliked the quality of light he saw there. He continued to Los Angeles. Once there, he chose not to shoot in Edendale, where many studios were, but in Hollywood. He also flouted the dictum that a film should run 20 minutes. He made his first film run 60 minutes, as long as a short play. The Squaw Man, 1914, co-directed by Oscar Apfel, was a sensation and it established the Lasky Company silent era advertisement. 1919, the first few years of the Lasky Company, soon to become famous players Lasky, were spent in making films non-stop, literally writing the language of film. DeMille adapted Belasco's dramatic lighting techniques to film technology, mimicking moonlight with Hollywood's first attempts at motivated lighting in The Warrens of Virginia. After 5 years and 30 hit films, DeMille became Hollywood's most successful director. In the silent era, he was renowned for Male and Female 1919, Manslaughter 1921, and The Godless Girl 1928. DeMille's trademark scenes included bathtubs, lion attacks, and Roman orgies. A number of his films featured scenes in two-color Technicolor. The immense popularity of DeMille's silent films enabled him to branch out into other areas. The Roaring Twenties were the boom years and DeMille took full advantage, opening the Mercury Aviation Company, one of America's first commercial airlines. He was also a real estate speculator, an underwriter of political campaigns, and a Bank of America executive, approving loans for other filmmakers. Sound era. When talking pictures were innovated in 1928, DeMille made a successful transition, offering his own innovations to the painful process. He devised a microphone boom and a soundproof camera blimp. He also popularized the camera crane. DeMille made stars of unknown actors: Gloria Swanson, B.B. Daniels, Rod LaRock, William Boyd, Claudette Colbert, and Charlton Heston. He also cast established stars such as Gary Cooper, Robert Preston, Paulette Goddard, and Frederick March in multiple pictures. DeMille displayed a loyalty to his performers, casting them repeatedly. They included Henry Wilcoxon, Julia Fay, Joseph Schildkraut, Ian Keith, Charles Bickford, Theodore Roberts, Akeem Tamaroff, and William Boyd. DeMille was credited by actor Edward G. Robinson with saving his career. Following his eclipse in the Hollywood blacklist, DeMille directing, DeMille had a reputation for autocratic behavior on the set, singling out and berating extras who were not paying attention. A number of these displays were thought to be staged, however, an exercise in discipline. He despised actors who were unwilling to take physical risks, especially when he had first demonstrated that the required stunt would not harm them. This occurred with Victor Mature in Samson, and Delilah Mature refused to wrestle Jackie the Lion, even though DeMille had just tussled with the lion. Proving that he was tame, DeMille told the actor that he was 100% yellow. Paulette Goddard's refusal to risk personal injury in a scene involving fire in Unconquered cost her DeMille's favor and a role in The Greatest Show on Earth. DeMille was adept at directing thousands of extras, and many of his pictures include spectacular set pieces: the toppling of the pagan temple in Samson and Delilah, train wrecks in The Road to Yesterday, Union Pacific and The Greatest Show on Earth, the destruction of an airship in Madam Satan, and the parting of the Red Sea in both versions of the Ten Commandments. DeMille first used three-strip Technicolor in Northwest Mounted Police 1940. Audiences liked its highly saturated color, so DeMille made no further black and white features. Showmanship as director. DeMille as producer of the CBS Radio Theater, 1937. DeMille was one of the first directors to become a celebrity in his own right. He cultivated the image of the omnipotent director, complete with megaphone, writing crop, and jodhpurs. From 1936 to 1944, DeMille hosted Lux Radio Theater, a weekly digest of current feature films. DeMille was respected by his peers, yet his individual films were sometimes criticized. Directorially, I think his pictures were the most horrible things I've ever seen in my life, said director William Wellman, but he put on pictures that made a fortune in that respect. He was better than any of us. Producer David O. Selznick wrote, there has appeared only one Cecil B. DeMille. He is one of the most extraordinarily able showmen of modern times. However much I may dislike some of his pictures, it would be very silly of me, as a producer of commercial motion pictures, to demean for an instant his unparalleled skill as a maker of mass entertainment. DeMille appeared as himself in numerous films, including the MGM comedy Free and Easy. He often appeared in his coming attraction trailers and narrated many of his later films, even stepping on screen to introduce the Ten Commandments. DeMille was immortalized in Billy Wilder's Sunset Boulevard when Gloria Swanson spoke the line, "All right, Mr. DeMille, I'm ready for my close-up." DeMille plays himself in the film. In the 1940s, DeMille continued to please the public. He averaged one film a year, most of them centered on historical figures or Bible stories. His first attempt at a drama set within a semi-documentary frame was The Greatest Show on Earth, a saga of circus performers released in 1952. His experiment gained him a nomination for Best Director and won an Oscar for Best Picture. The Ten Commandments in 1954, DeMille began his last film, the production for which he is best remembered, The Ten Commandments, on November 7, 1954, while in Egypt filming the Exodus sequence for the Ten Commandments. DeMille, who was 73, climbed a 107-foot-33. In the months prior to his death, DeMille was researching a film biography of Robert Baden-Powell, 1st Baron Baden-Powell, the founder of the Scout movement. DeMille asked David Niven to star in the film, but it was never made. DeMille was also planning a film about the space race, as well as another biblical epic, this one about the Book of Revelation. Personal life. DeMille's tomb at Hollywood Forever Cemetery. DeMille married Constance Adams on August 16, 1902 and had one child, Cecilia. The couple also adopted an orphan child, Catherine Lester. In the early 1920s, her father had been killed in World War I and her mother had died of tuberculosis. Catherine became an actress at Paramount Pictures, ultimately gaining his approval in 1937. She married actor Anthony Quinn in the 1920s. The DeMilles adopted two sons, John and Richard, the latter of whom became a notable filmmaker, writer, and psychologist. He had an older brother, William. Their sister Agnes died in childhood. William later named a daughter after her, Agnes DeMille. The famed dancer choreographer was DeMille's niece. DeMille died of a heart ailment at age 77 in January 1959. Politics. DeMille was a lifelong conservative Republican activist. He greatly admired Herbert Hoover. In 1944, he was the master of ceremonies at the massive rally organized by David O. Selznick in the Los Angeles Coliseum in support of the Dewey Bricker ticket, as well as Governor Earl Warren of California, who would become Dewey's running mate in 1948 and later the Chief Justice of the United States. The gathering drew 93,000, with short speeches by Hedda Hopper and Walt Disney. Among those in attendance were Ann Southern, Ginger Rogers, Randolph Scott, Adolph Menjo, Gary Cooper, and Walter Pidgeon. Though the rally drew a good response, most Hollywood celebrities who took a public position sided with the Roosevelt-Truman ticket. DeMille was a Freemason and a member of Prince of Orange Lodge No. 16 in New York City in 1954, Secretary of the Air Force Harold E. Talbot asked DeMille for help in designing the cadet uniforms at the newly established United States Air Force Academy. DeMille's designs, most notably his design of the distinctive cadet parade uniform, won praise from Air Force and Academy leadership, were ultimately adopted, and are still worn by cadets in the early 1950s. DeMille was recruited by Alan Dulles and Frank Wisner to serve on the board of the Anti-Communist National Committee for a Free Europe, the public face of the organization that oversaw the Radio Free Europe service. Race and religion. DeMille drew on his Jewish and Protestant heritage to convey a message of tolerance. The Crusades was the first film to show accord between Christians and Muslims. DeMille received more than a dozen awards from Jewish religious and cultural groups, including B'nai B'rith. In 1954, he was seeking approval for a lavish remake of his 1923 silent film The Ten Commandments. He went before the Paramount Board of Directors, which was mostly Jewish American. The members rejected his proposal, even though his last two films, Samson and Delilah and The Greatest Show on Earth, had been record-breaking hits. Adolf Zukor, the chairman of the board, rebuked the members, saying, "We have just lived through a war where our people were systematically executed. Here we have a man who made a film praising the Jewish people, that tells of Samson, one of the legends of our scripture. Now he wants to make the life of Moses. We should get down on our knees to Cecil and say thank you." DeMille did not have an exact budget proposal for the project, and it promised to be the most costly in Hollywood history. Still, the members unanimously approved it. Death in the early hours of January 21, 1959. DeMille died of heart failure. DeMille's funeral was held on January 23 at St. Stephen's Episcopal Church. He was entombed at the Hollywood Memorial Cemetery, now known as Hollywood Forever Legacy. DeMille. In 1952, DeMille received hundreds of awards, commendations, and honors in his lifetime. Posthumous honors. For his contribution to the motion picture and radio industry, DeMille has 2 stars on the Hollywood Walk of Fame. The first, for radio contributions, is located at 6240 Vine Street. The second star is located at 1725 Vine Street. 2 schools are named after him. Cecil B. DeMille Middle School, in Long Beach, California, closed and demolished in 2007 to make way for a new high school, and Cecil B. DeMille Elementary School in Midway City, California. The former film building at Chapman University in Orange, California is named in honor of DeMille. The Lawrence and Christina Dodge College of Film and Media Arts now resides in Marion Knotts Studios. The Golden Globe's annual Cecil B. DeMille Award recognizes lifetime achievement in the film industry. The moving image collection of Cecil B. DeMille is held at the Academy Film Archive and includes home movies, outtakes, and never-before-seen test footage. Filmography. DeMille made 70 features in spite of careful storage in his film vaults. 7 films were lost to nitrate decomposition. All were early silent films. The titles are The Arab, The Wild Goose Chase, Chimmy Fadden, The Dream Girl, We Can't Have Everything, The Devil Stone, and The Squaw Man. The 1918 remake. Roughly 20 of his silent features are available in commercial DVD format. The sound films are in 3 groups. 1. The 3 films DeMille produced at MGM are now owned by Warner Brothers through Turner Entertainment. 2. The films he made at Paramount between 1932 and 1947 were sold by that company to EMCA, Limited in 1957, and are available through the television division of NBC Universal. 3. DeMille's last 3 films were not sold to EMCA, and at present remain with Paramount Television. Distribution for those films is handled by Trifecta Entertainment. The Virginian 1914, What's His Name 1914, The Man from Home 1914, Rose of the Rancho 1914, The Ghost Breaker 1914, The Girl of the Golden West 1915, After 5 1915, The Warrens of Virginia 1915, The Unafraid 1915, The Captive 1915, The Wild Goose Chase 1915, Lost the Arab 1915, Chimmy Fadden 1915, Lost Kindling 1915, Carmen 1915, Chimmy Fadden Out West 1915, The Cheat 1915, Temptation 1915, Lost the Golden Chance 1915, The Trail of the Lonesome Pine 1916, The Heart of Nora Flynn 1916, Maria Rosa 1916, The Dream Girl 1916, Lost Joan the Woman 1917, Lost and Won 1917, A Romance of the Redwoods 1917, The Little American 1917, The Woman God Forgot 1917, Nan of Music Mountain 1917, The Devil Stone 1917, The Whispering Chorus 1918, Old Wives for New 1918, We Can't Have Everything 1918, Lost Till I Come Back to You 1918, The Squaw Man 1918, Don't Change Your Husband 1919. For Better, For Worse 1919 Male and Female 1919 Why Change Your Wife 1920 Something to Think About 1920 Forbidden Fruit 1921 The Affairs of Anatole 1921 Fool's Paradise 1921 Saturday Night 1922 Manslaughter 1922 Adam's Rib 1923 The Ten Commandments 1923 Triumph 1924 Feet of Clay 1924 Lost the Golden Bed 1925 The Road to Yesterday 1925 The Volga Boatman 1926 The King of Kings 1927 Walking Back 1928 The Godless Girl 1929 Sound Films Dynamite 1929 Madame Satan 1930 The Squaw Man 1931 The Sign of the Cross 1932 This Day and Age 1933 Four Frightened People 1934 Cleopatra 1934 The Crusades 1935 The Plainsman 1936 The Buccaneer 1938 Union Pacific 1939 Northwest Mounted Police 1940 Reap the Wild Wind 1942 The Story of Drive, Wassel 1944 Unconquered 1947 California's Golden Beginning 1948, Short Subject. Samson and Delilah 1949 The Greatest Show on Earth 1952 The Ten Commandments 1956 The Buccaneer 1958, Producer-Actor A Trip to Paramountown 1922, Short Subject Felix in Hollywood 1923, Short Subject Hollywood 1923 Jens Manson I America 1947 Variety Girl 1947 Sunset Boulevard 1950 Is Himself The Fallbrook Story 1951, Short Subject Son of Paleface 1950 The Greatest Show on Earth 1952, Narrator The Ten Commandments 1956, Intro and Narrator The Buccaneer 1958, Narrator Awards Year. Award Category Title of Work 1950 Academy Award Academy Honorary Award 1953 Academy Award Best Picture The Greatest Show on Earth 1953 Academy Award Irving G. Thalberg Memorial Award 1939 Palme d'Or Union Pacific 1953 Directors Guild of America Award Lifetime Achievement Award 1952 Golden Globe Award Cecil B. DeMille Award 1953 Golden Globe Award Best Director The Greatest Show on Earth 1958 Laurel Awards Top Producer, Director, see also Biography Portal Massachusetts Portal North Carolina Portal New Jersey Portal Los Angeles Portal California Portal Theater Portal Film Portal Conservatism Portal Christianity Portal References Notes Carrot DeMille Random House Webster's Unabridged Dictionary Carrot Cecil B. DeMille Obituary Variety January 28, 1959 Carrot Presley, Cecilia DeMille, and Mark Allen Vieira Cecil B. DeMille, The Art of the Hollywood Epic Running Press 2014 P12 Carrot Hull Betty Lynn, Denver's Elitch Gardens, Spinning a Century of Dreams. Big Earth Publishing, 2003, p. 49. Carrot Lowe, Walter October 22, 1956 DeMille at 75 Still Creating Kentucky New Era Retrieved April 29, 2014. Carrot Weiss, Marshall December 5, 2003 How DeMille Created a Sanctuary Out of the Exodus ForwardCom Retrieved February 21, 2014. Carrot Presley, Cecil B. DeMille, p. 29 Carrot Presley, Cecil B. DeMille, p. 375 Carrot Presley, Cecil B. DeMille, p. 259 Carrot Presley, Cecil B. DeMille, p. 344 Carrot Presley, Cecil B. DeMille, p. 363 Carrot Brownlow 1976, p. Carrot, Cecil DeMille, 77, Pioneer of Movies, Dead in Hollywood, NeTimescom January 22, 1959 Retrieved December 19, 2012. New York, Vestal Press, 1990 ISBN 1-879511-24X Presley, Cecilia DeMille, and Mark Allen Vieira Cecil B. DeMille, The Art of the Hollywood Epic Philadelphia, Running Press, 2014 ISBN 978-0-7624-5490-7 Wiener, Tim 2007 Legacy of Ashes, The History of the CIA New York, Doubleday ISBN 978-0-3855-1445-3 External links Wikimedia Commons has media related to Cecil B. DeMille Sources Official website Cecil B. DeMille at the Internet Broadway Database Cecil B. DeMille at the Internet Movie Database Cecil B. DeMille at the TCM Movie Database Works by or about Cecil B. DeMille at Internet Archive Works by or about Cecil B. DeMille in Libraries WorldCat Catalog Cecil B. DeMille at Virtual History Cecil B. DeMille's Early Films Costs and Grosses by David Pierce, Silent Film Bookshelf. Criticism and Commentary. Higashi, Sumiko. Cecil B. DeMille and American Culture, The Silent Era. Berkeley, University of California Press, C1994 1994. Free online, UC Press e-books collection. Bibliography of books and articles about DeMille via UC Berkeley Media Resources Center. Newsweek, September 2010, How Cecil B. DeMille Created Modern Hollywood. Archival materials. The Mary Roberts Reinhardt Papers, includes conversations with DeMille about her plays. Finding Aid. Author, Garrett Schroth. 1958 Cecil B. DeMille's Birth Record. DeMille, 1900 Census, 1910 Census, 1920 Census, 1930 Census, 1942 World War II Draft Registrations. VE Films directed by Cecil B. DeMille. Silent the Squaw Man 1914. Brewster's Millions 1914. The Mastermind 1914. The Only Son 1914. The Man on the Box 1914. The Call of the North 1914. The Virginian 1914. What's His Name 1914. The Man from Home 1914. Rose of the Rancho 1914. The Ghost Breaker 1914. The Girl of the Golden West 1915. After 5 1915. The Warrens of Virginia 1915. The Unafraid 1915. The Captive 1915. The Wild Goose Chase 1915. The Arab 1915. Chimmy Fadden 1915. Kindling 1915. Carmen 1915. Chimmy Fadden. Out West 1915. The Cheat 1915. Temptation 1915. The Golden Chance 1915. The Trail of the Lonesome Pine 1916. The Heart of Nora Flynn 1916. Maria Rosa 1916. The Dream Girl 1916. Joan the Woman 1916. Lost and Won 1917. A Romance of the Redwoods 1917. The Little American 1917. The Woman God Forgot 1917. Nan of Music Mountain 1917. The Devil's Stone 1917. The Whispering Chorus 1918. Old Wives for New 1918. We Can't Have Everything 1918. Till I Come Back to You 1918. The Squaw Man 1918. Don't Change Your Husband 1919. For Better, For Worse 1919. Male and Female 1919. Why Change Your Wife 1920. Something to Think About 1920. Forbidden Fruit 1921. The Affairs of Anatole 1921. Fool's Paradise 1921. Saturday Night 1922. Manslaughter 1922. Adam's Rib 1923. The Ten Commandments 1923. Triumph 1924. Feet of Clay 1924. The Golden Bed 1925. The Road to Yesterday 1925. The Volga Boatman 1926. The King of Kings 1927. Walking Back 1928. The Godless Girl 1929. Sound Dynamite 1929. Madam Satan 1930. The Squaw Man 1931. The Sign of the Cross 1932. This Day and Age 1933. Four Frightened People 1934. Cleopatra 1934. The Crusades 1935. The Plainsman 1936. The Buccaneer 1938. Union Pacific 1939. Northwest Mounted Police 1940. Reap the Wild Wind 1942. The Story of Drive, Wassel 1944. Unconquered 1947. California's Golden Beginning 1948. Samson and Delilah 1949. The Greatest Show on Earth 1952. The Ten Commandments 1956. The Buccaneer 1958. VE Academy Honorary Award 1928-1950. Warner Brothers, Charlie Chaplin 1928. Walt Disney 1932. Shirley Temple 1934. D.W. Griffith 1935. The March of Time, W. Howard Green and Harold Rawson 1936. Edgar Bergen, W. Howard Green, Museum of Modern Art Film Library, Max Sennett 1937. J. Arthur Ball, Walt Disney, Deanna Durbin and Mickey Rooney, Gordon Jennings, Jan DeMella, Devereaux Jennings, Erman Roberts, Art Smith, Farcho Edwart, Loyal Griggs, Lauren L. Ryder, Harry D. Mills, Louis Messingkopf, Walter Oberst, Oliver T. Marsh and Alan Davey, Harry Warner 1938, Douglas Fairbanks, Judy Garland, William Cameron Menzies, Motion Picture Relief Fund, Gene Herschelt, Ralph Morgan, Ralph Bloch, Conrad Nagel, Technicolor Company 1939, Bob Hope, Nathan Levinson 1940, Walt Disney, William Garrity, John N. A. Hawkins, and the RCA Manufacturing Company, Leopold Stokowski and his associates, Ray Scott, British Ministry of Information 1941, Charles Boyer, Noel Coward, Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer 1942, George Powell 1943, Bob Hope, Margaret O'Brien 1944, Republic Studio, Daniel J. Bloomberg, and the Republic Studio Sound Department, Walter Wanger, The House I Live In, Peggy Ann Garner 1945, Harold Russell, Laurence Olivier, Ernst Lubitsch, Claude Jarman Jr. 1946, James Baskett, Thomas Armat, William Nicholas Seelig, Albert E. Smith, and George Kirk Spoor, Bill and Coo, Shushine 1947 Walter Wanger, Monsieur Vincent, Sid Grauman, Adolf Zukor 1948 Jean Herschel, Fred Astaire, Cecil B. DeMille, The Bicycle Thief 1949 Louis B. Mayer, George Murphy, The Walls of Malapaga 1950-1951-1975 Gene Kelly, Rashomon 1951 Marion C. Cooper, Bob Hope, Harold Lloyd, George Mitchell, Joseph M. Schenck, Forbidden Games 1952 20th, Century Fox Film Corporation, Bell. 1953 Bausch. Charlie Chaplin 1971 Charles S. Boren, Edward G. Robinson 1972 Henri Langlois, Groucho Marx 1973 Howard Hawks, Jean Renoir 1974 Mary Pickford 1975-1976 2000 Margaret Booth 1977 Walter Lance, Laurence Olivier, King Vidor, Museum of Modern Art Department of Film 1978 Hal Elias, Alec Guinness 1979 Henry Fonda 1980 Barbara Stanwyck 1981 Mickey Rooney 1982 Hal Roach 1983 James Stewart, National Endowment for the Arts 1984 Paul Newman, Alex North 1985 Ralph Bellamy 1986 Eastman Kodak Company, National Film Board of Canada 1988